Hi, everyone, and welcome to the Cure Radio Show. I hope you can join us. Today, we will be talking about protecting each other, protecting our loved ones and our children and our siblings. But we will always start with a little prayer. And it's a beautiful sunny day, of course, in Miami. We're blessed. Blessed to be alive and blessed to wake up every day. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you will renew the face of the earth. O God, you taught the hearts of your faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit. Grant that, by the gift of the same Spirit, we may be truly wise, and always rejoice in his consolation. Amen. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. So, another beautiful day. And Bobby wants to say hello.
Of course, Bobby says hello. Thank you for being with us. It's going to be an interesting show. We're not going to have video of the guest, but it's going to be audio. And hope you guys enjoy it.
I mean, we all see ourselves in life having to protect one another, protect the most vulnerable, and if we're not able to do so in person, we can do so by our prayers. God will protect, and all we need to do is ask.
And get more dogs.
After all, he did say, ask and you shall receive. You mean like a guard dog?
Yeah.
Or a little dog that sounds big when he barks.
Yeah, that too.
Nobody sees what's behind the door.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Especially when they hear the bark. Right? Some small dogs that bark a lot.
Some dogs, their bark is bigger than their bite.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe that's all you need.
Yep. And the song is going to start soon. Which one is the first song, Amy?
Well, it's a pretty fun song.
Yeah.
Yes.
You always get good songs.
I try. God is my help. He's good to me.
Shall what I can put I a say? Picture of you? It's one time alongside JW. My bestie and your bestie sit down by the fire. Your bestie says she want parties, so can we make these flames go higher? Talking about hey now, hey now, hey now, hey now. I go on it. Chucky Morphina, Anane, Chucky Morphina, Anane. Start my truck, let's all jump in. Here we go together. Nice cool breeze and big palm trees. I tell you life don't get no better. Talking about hey now, hey now, hey now, hey now. I go on it. Chucky Morphina, Anane, Chucky Morphina, Anane. Okay, I'm a manguele. Step on the dancing floor. Hips be winding, beat rewinding, take it to the island way. Hey, your baby mama, put on your dancing shoes. One poppy poppy blow now, take you to the max now. Jam in the small jam way, jam in the small jam way. My bestie, your bestie, dancing by the fire. Your bestie says you want parties, so can we make this place go higher?
The Cure with Aimee Cabo. Life can bring many difficult situations, domestic violence, addictions, poverty, and even sexual abuse by your loved ones. Welcome, Aimee Cabo and The Cure.
Good afternoon, and welcome to The Cure Radio Show. I'm your host, Aimee Cabo, with my amazing partner, Boris.
Hi, guys.
Our show is available live on your radio, also live through our app, The Cure, on any smartphone, throughout social media, and our website, godisthecure.com. We broadcast live from Miami through satellite, available on traditional radio, and on Sirius XM, channel 131, the next day. Also, any podcast player. We are now reaching approximately 5 million people monthly in Facebook alone. So thank you to our social media followers, and mostly thank you to God. Nothing's possible without Him, at least nothing that succeeds. This show was created to expose the truth, educate, and provide comfort. We provide testimonials to let people know that we are not alone. And in this show, the testimony started with me. We also have experts and inspirational speakers that can help. God was the only cure for me after everything else failed. But I hope that at least we can be there for each other. Life is challenging, but know this, there is a God. Who is our Father? Is omnipotent, loves us dearly, and never forsakes us. So there's always hope. That was that song, I Go by Justin Wellington. And this is my message to you, thanks to the Holy Spirit. Miracles happen. Big movement is on, coming our way. Allows only so much until sweet Lord saves the day. In a sweeping motion, our bestie takes the win. Nothing better when he gives and you spin. Reworks the weather, gather what's his these days. Raising great saints who live by his holy ways. Igniting flames of his spirit to full throttle. The genie is now out of the bottle. Flies higher than Aladdin's carpet, vessels of peace. Commit to decrease, invite him in to increase. Sun not going down, but gleam of his light. Carry us through the wails of this fight. Mary, full of grace, whose prayers are surely heard. Eyes of mercy, our advocate, mirror of his word. His love and name proclaim often out loud. As his base, hope to make him proud. Today we will be talking about protecting our loved ones with our special guest, Barbara Austin, author of Not in the Fire. Barbara helps at her local church and shares her story of perseverance and courage. Barbara, welcome to The Cure.
Thank you.
So grateful to have you with us.
Thank you. That was beautiful.
Oh, thank you. Thank God. Big God, what can I say? Barbara, tell us briefly about your story.
Well, it's about my struggle and how the Lord got me through my life, because there's only God would I still be alive. I had a very difficult life, and the Lord wanted me to write it all down so people can see that God gets us through anything, you know. He's there. He's just waiting for us to ask him to help. And that's what my book's about, and about my life, and how God got me through everything.
So you learned that you were never defeated despite despair.
No, in
so certain difficult times in your life.
I've had a lot of difficult times. Do you want me to tell of one?
Sure.
Okay, well, the one that comes to my mind the most at this time is that when I was only about 7 years old, I had a stepfather that was molesting us, and I was hiding everywhere to get away from him. He one time was enough for me, and I just prayed God would protect me. And he did. He had me hiding in the closets, behind the claw tub in the bathroom. I even went up in the attic, and I slept in the attic bedroom upstairs. It was away from everybody, and he couldn't find me. One day he found me, and he came up the stairs, and I was laying underneath this gigantic hornet nest, a paper wasp. And they won't hurt you. I would learn from my grandmother, because she had one over her rocker. She loved to watch them. And as soon as the Lord just told me to lay still, that they would not bother me. And as soon as he came up and said, "I found you," he looked up and he saw that nest, and they all literally swarmed out and chased him down the stairs, stinging him all over the place. He slammed the door, and they had to take him to the hospital. Wow. And those paper wasps went right back up in the nest, and they never bothered me. They just stayed there, and it was beautiful. I just I just was amazed, and I was just a kid, but you know, as a child, I believed everything so innocently that we lose that as adults. But when I was told of all the Bible stories and the things that God did with the kids and the people and the stories, I believed it. And that's the way it was. It was going to work for me too. And I hung on to that through my life because God is powerful. He can do anything. And so my book's about all the wonderful things he's done for me.
And it's true that really all he needs from us is faith. Of course, we have to do our part. But faith is a big part of it. And I have this theory that the devil attacks us when we're little because he knows we're precious to God.
That's right.
And we're probably going to make an impact. And it's going to hurt God the most. And that's why he goes for the little ones. And so if you have the potential to get close to God, he will try destroying you since you're very little.
Right.
But, you know, God, he stands by our side. And just like he protected you that time, he protects our minds.
Yep.
He protects our sanity. And but I know that from my personal experience, all my terrible childhood things that happened, I didn't know they were terrible. I didn't suffer much when I was a child. I only suffered as an adult when I realized it was so wrong. But like that, God will protect children. And so, and it's because children have this dependency on God. It's to know that he's our hero and he's our everything. And sometimes we lose
track of that. That's why we need to tell the children. The problem is a lot of kids don't even know about Jesus. They don't know to turn to him. They don't know he's there. And they're lonely and scared, and they don't understand. They have nowhere to turn but violence. So we need to let the children know that Jesus is there.
Right. And that's, God has entrusted us with these innocent souls. And we have to do our part to give them that same kind of faith that we have as kids that have somehow gotten lost in generations when they took God out of schools and they took God out of a lot of places. But then we're seeing this increase in childhood depression and childhood suicide more than we've ever heard before. And it's going to come a point in time that people are going to realize that we actually need God, and God is important. And without God, it's night and day. I mean, if you don't have God, so many terrible tragedies can happen. But if you have God, yes, life is still difficult. Yes, you will still be challenged, but God will make the best out of it, and God will help you through it.
That's right.
He will help you handle it. And of course, even then, God does not give us anything that we cannot handle.
Right.
No matter what. But it's just so much better with God. It's much more tolerable, and we make better decisions, and we cope better. So those kind of same skills that we learn through hard knocks in life, we have to hand over to our children because they haven't had those experiences. So they're not so prepared. And because we've had experiences, we can hand that knowledge down to them and be there for them, because it isn't just about taking care of ourselves, but taking care of one another. I think that when we die, it's not so great that we tell God we did so great for ourselves as much as what did you do for your brother.
Right.
And
totally agree.
And so also you have stories about being there for your siblings and how you were able to protect them. And after this short break, we're going to talk about that, because that's something that we can all learn from.
Yeah, we'll be right back. Stay with us. We'll talk about protecting our loved ones with Barbara Austin, author of Not in the Fire. We'll be right back.
We will be right back with Aimee Cabo and The Cure.
I woke up in a stranger's bed with pins and needles in my head. And the clock ticking off the wall. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I don't even know myself. I wish I could be someone else, but I don't have a clue at all. Oh yeah. I'm sinking. You're waiting. I'm thinking something's gone.
Now we will continue with Aimee Cabo and The Cure.
Welcome back, and thanks for tuning in.
Remember, you can listen to the radio show live on our app, or on YouTube, or later as a podcast, whatever podcast.
That was Something's Gotta Give by All Time Low. Encourage love, amplify Jesus Christ, and resist all sin. Express His goodness within, don't allow evil in. Things going wrong shouldn't happen much. Time to step up, we need His touch. Satan disguised as a sheep hopes we slowly slip away. At our lowest, realize there must be another way. On knees pray, resenting having gone astray. The God who stays helps, don't delay. Before changing, stay close or return, never late. To be with God, ordained has been our fate. Gives strength, restores youth, and heals. New spirit, in good time He reveals. Gently He calls, assures growth to bring us back. Days filled with prayer, nothing we ever lack. Virtue follows, tends the heart contrite. Anointed by grace, united in light. We will continue talking about protecting our loved ones with Barbara Austin, author of Not in the Fire. Rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. Give thanks in all circumstances. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. 1 Thessalonians 5:16-18. Barbara, before we went into break, you spoke of the stories of the kids in the Bibles and that you believe them. And obviously somebody was talking to you about the Bible and teaching you those things. And
yes, I went to Sunday school my whole life. I had neighbors that would invite me. I had aunts that would pick me up and take me. School teachers even asked if I wanted to go. But unfortunately, none of my other siblings were interested. I was the only one. And so I think that's why, you know, they struggled more than I did. But because of all of it, I learned a lot, and I decided that I had to take care of everybody. I even had to take care of my mother because she had some mental conditions, and working two jobs to feed all of us and making bad choices with the men in her life. And she had me quit school to take care of her kids, and I did. And I became more like a second mother than a sister. But I did things with them. I had fun with them, and I taught them things, and I told them about the Bible stories, and so they'd have them. But I don't know, it just never clicked until they got older. Thank God that five of them have accepted the Lord now, so I'm grateful for that.
Perhaps because of your influence, the difference between them and you is that you built a faith, a strong foundation with right. God. And that's where you were able to better cope with things, and you were more responsible, and you made better opinion, better, you know, decisions, because God does, He shows us how to do the right thing, and He guides us. But for your siblings, they had it a little bit more difficult. It's always more difficult without God. Nonetheless, He's always there for us.
And I stood up for them. They saw me, my strength of not being afraid of my stepfathers and standing up for them. And they had a struggle for standing up for themselves, and I kept trying to teach them, you need to stand up.
Now, not all of us have these experiences. Not all of us know the stories of the Bible or go to Sunday schools or even have that kind of influence. I know as for myself, all I knew is how to pray, and I did not know anything about the Bible. In fact, the Bible was used in a different way. But I did have a dream where Jesus came down, and He let me know that I can come to Him and that He would rescue me as long as I turn to Him, as long as I come to Him. And we've all been in a point in life where something's got to give, and we're just in a rut, and we forget that Christ is always there. All we have to do is turn to Him and run to Him, no matter how dark our circumstance, no matter what we've done, no matter where we are. But
that meet us where we are.
Yeah, he'll meet us wherever we are, but that which you did, being there for your siblings, yeah, that saved their life, Barbara.
Right. Yeah.
Because I know, I've been there. I've had those experiences. It isn't easy. I mean, nothing in life is easy. I went through many years of depression. When I stopped praying, you have to pray. You have to ask God for help. And that's how you keep him close. If you do nothing else right, at least pray. And everything will fall into place thereafter.
At
least that's how it happened for me. Prayer is very important daily.
Oh, yeah, it definitely is.
And
prayer to me is talking to God, and it's no special way to talk. Some people tell me they don't know how you pray. It's just talking to Jesus. You just open up and share your life and talk to him.
Yeah, he wants you to talk to him about everything and anything. As if he was your imaginary best friend. And any time that you speak to him, whether it be in words written or words expressed, that's prayer.
Right.
Now, there's also prayers you can find on the internet, you can find on books, you can, you know, at least the Our Father we should know. But anytime that you communicate with God, anytime that you spend time with him, remember he spends with us 24 hours a day.
Exactly.
We could spend some time with him in return. And but you were able to find God in fiery events in your life with that gentle, silent voice. Tell us more, because there's times we don't hear him at all.
I just learned early on, I guess, when I was real little, that voice was there. He was just always talking to me, and it was like the only, when I was told that I had a heavenly father in heaven, I just, you know, would talk to him all the time, you know, and share my troubles and everything with him. But that's how I did it, you know. That's just the relationship that I had with Jesus and with God, and the still small voice is still there. It's always there. He's just, you've got to just be quiet for a minute and listen, and he will share with you what he wants you to do, and he'll encourage you, and you know you can feel his arms holding you when you're sad. You just focus on Jesus. And
well, everyone has a unique relationship with God. He sees us as if we're his only child. And I know, as for me, God communicates when I'm not even expecting it.
Right.
Anyway, we'll continue talking a little bit later after a short break about protecting our loved ones with Barbara Austin, author of Not in the Fire. Please stay with us. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back with Aimee Cabo and The Cure.
I can't write one song that's not about you. Can't drink without thinking about you. Is it too late to tell you that everything means nothing if I can't have you?
I'm in Toronto and I got this view, but I might as well be in a hotel room. Yeah, it doesn't matter cause I'm so consumed, spending all my nights reading texts from you. Oh, I'm good at keeping my distance. I know that you're the feeling I'm missing. You know that I hate to admit it, but everything means nothing if I can't have you.
I can't write one song that's not about you. Can't drink without thinking about you. Is it too late to tell you that everything means nothing if I can't have you?
So sorry that my timing's off, but I can't move on if we're still gonna talk. Is it wrong for me to not want half? I want all of you, all the strings attached. Oh.
And now we will continue with Aimee Cabo and The Cure.
Welcome back, and thanks for being with us. Remember, we're live every Saturday at 1 p.m. Eastern on your radio, on our app, The Cure, the podcast, The Cure, and our website, godisthecure.com. That song was If I Can't Have You by Shawn Mendes. God wants love and have him in mind every time. Would be lost if not for Christ, most sublime. Hope be scarce and strength diminish. He's the start and ultimate finish. Dreading temptations, darkness, crosses, and sorrow, stand tall because he lives, we face tomorrow. Love as we should, be devout, don't doubt. Salvation is his, we can't be without. But for God who completes, much comes out right. Champions our fight, paving way to his light. Removes pain, render to his loving care. Blessings to come, hard to prepare. Worthy of all we have to offer in our daily deeds. Merciful, gracious, our needs God exceeds. Turn to him, trust he sees us through. Dedicate to his glory all we do. We will continue talking about overcoming, helping each other and protecting one another with Barbara Austin, author of Not in the Fire. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him would not perish, but have eternal life. John 3:16. Barbara, I think that I was so difficult and I put my husband and my family through so much just because God wanted to show them all how big he is and what great big miracles he can do. And trust me, just the other day I was thinking, wow, remember this and remember that. And we were all, I mean, kids can get to the point of cutting themselves, of getting really, really dark. And God could save each and every one of you. Miracles happen all the time. And the greatest miracles happen when you're the farthest apart. And, but it was thanks to my supportive family, my husband who didn't give up on me, my children who came through. And we all stuck together. We all returned to God. We all ran to God and he rescued us all. But it was important that we were there for each other. These days now are blessed and miracles happen often. I do focus. I'm happy with the little things that happen. If I'm not on my routine, nonetheless, he gives me perfect timing. Everything comes out well. I've learned how to do things perfectly. I'm thinking and better than I ever have before and making the best decisions. And to that, to me, that's a miracle. But tell me, what is the important that we help those around us? Because there's times that the enemy does attack and we are at our darkest and are at our lowest.
I think, you know, that you're right. You're totally right. We need each other. And not just for my siblings, but there's been, you know, you can, sometimes you can just step forward to help your neighbor or someone close. I've had a heart for kids on the street. And in my past, I have gone up and talked to them and asked them if they need anything. Can I help them with anything? You know, and a few times I even brought them into my home and let them sleep on the couch and helped them find a connection to get them some help. And sometimes we need to step up and be, you know, you got to observe and use your sense because you got to make sure you're safe and because you don't want to bring someone unsafe into your home. But you can pray for them. A lot of times I'll talk to them and say, can I pray for you? And, you know, it's important to let people know that you love them, that there's so much unlove out there. There's the kids there. The Covenant House is my favorite place to deal with because they help kids everywhere. And there's so many. Oh, my lands. I can't believe how many children and young people are just kind of abandoned and left to survive on their own, and they're just kids. They're just kids. They need love, and this place is awesome because they teach them about God, and they help them to find their selves and connect with their other kids that have been through tough times too. There's a lot of pain out there. There's a lot of, if you just open your eyes, sometimes I think we don't want to see it because it hurts too much, but sometimes you really need to just look around you and see all the pain that's around.
Well, this is what it comes down to. What are we willing to do for Christ, considering what he did for us? Are we willing to step out of our comfort zone, take a chance, willing to suffer after how he suffered for us? If we earn the opportunity where we can foster a child or adopt a child, should we? Would we? What are we going to do when we face our maker? And he asks, did you? And so that's something that, okay, so we want to look out for our own and protect ourselves and not take a chance. But life is about taking chances. Life is about heroic virtue. Life is about not letting fear control you. And life is about setting aside doubt and replacing it with hope. Life is about trusting God and knowing that he will provide. So it's a matter of what are you willing to do to pay it forward? And how will you pay it forward? And if at the very least, yes, if you can't do much, at least pray. Pray for children every day. Because those are the most innocent among us. And those are the ones that are most vulnerable and the ones who least deserve the suffering that they go through.
Yes, exactly. And sometimes God will ask you to take a child. And are you going to obey and take that child? Or are you going to say no? I think that you have to say yes myself. I've had God give me 3 kids in my old age, and I didn't think twice about it because I knew it was God telling me to take them. They were in bad situations, and they needed just a loving home. And sometimes it's good for kids to be not with their birth parents. This sounds hard, but some birth parents are really messed up and they can't find their way out. Why should their children suffer?
Yes.
Their kids need to start over, and in the whole generational problems of troubles.
So if God says sacrifice for righteousness, is it not important to do the right thing regardless of how difficult it is?
Right. And those 3 kids have been the biggest blessing. I love them dearly. It's like they're my own.
Being a foster child myself, I don't think that most of the kids are looking for trouble or looking to hurt someone. They've been hurt themselves. And they're just so grateful to have someone that cares, somebody that's willing to love them and to take them in. It's like the stray dog that you get from the street, not comparing kids to animals, but isn't that the best animal you have? The one you rescued from the street, isn't he the most grateful? And kids are pretty much the same. They're just glad that finally they get a break in life, and you can be that break.
They want love.
After
they want
all,
structure.
Forget not the benefits that God has done for us. Has he not been there for us and amplified our life with love and blessings? And would we not want to share the joy? We would not want to give someone else that opportunity and return the favor he has given us.
Right, exactly.
And so we all have to just consider, our part. We're here for a reason, and it's mostly each other. That's what I believe. It's not to be here for ourselves, but see how we can be of service to one another.
That's right, exactly. I've even had the pleasure of meeting other family members of the kids at the game.
Oh, what's up? We will definitely talk about that when we return.
We will be right back with Aimee Cabo and The Cure.
head full of questions. How can you measure up to deserve affection, to ever be enough for this existence? When did it get so hard? Your heart is beating, alive and breathing, and there's a reason why. You are essential, not accidental, and you should realize you are beloved. It pulls you under and you just fall away. Is anybody gonna hear you call? Oh. But there's a purpose under the surface, and you don't have to drown. Let me remind you that love will find you. Let it lift you out. You are beloved.
And now we will continue with Aimee Cabo and The Cure.
Hi again, and thanks for tuning in. We're live every Saturday at 1 p.m. Eastern on your radio, our app The Cure, and social media. Look for God is the Cure.
Hello, it is a podcast. Just look for God is the Cure with Aimee Cabo, wherever podcasts are.
That song was Beloved by Jordan Feliz. Our daughter suggested that song. It's beautiful. Who thirst is quenched, not on the sideline or fence. Through him we love perfectly. His is immense. Blinders fall and things start to make sense. God as our fortress and only defense. His beloved, what can we do for so many graces? Eternal, merciful love, to him endless praises. Presence essential, a nothing without. O Jesus, our lives, no doubt. Imply what's good, not evil. Let his holiness guide. Encourage and show we are on the same side. To be one, serving mighty God every way. Glorify and abide, commit each day. The poor souls in need for which to him we pray. His blessings to come we could never repay. To have open eyes and feel his press and feel his embrace. A new world of joy, blessed by grace. We will continue talking about overcoming difficulties in our lives and being there for each other, protecting one another, with Barbara Austin, author of Not in the Fire. But the Lord is faithful, and he will strengthen you and protect you from the evil one. 2 Thessalonians 3:3.
Barbara, despite the many troubles we have, we always have the Lord deliver us from them. But how do we let the people around us know that, or around for their own troubles?
We do it by our life and how we live our life. We show them by being different than the world. You talk about Jesus. You know, I'm talking to God and I'll say, "Geez, I'm going to pray about that." And people will ask me, "Why are you being so nice?" I'll say, "Because the Lord says we're supposed to take care of each other, and I'm trying to obey." I mean, we have to reach out and see a need and help and keep praying. Be willing to walk up and say, "I, you know, you look like you're having struggle. Can I help?"
or can I pray for you if you don't mind? Or give them $5, you know, go buy them a hamburger at McDonald's. I mean, there's all kinds of ways, just little ways that mean them a lot. And when you do this in your life and people see you doing these things, they see Jesus. And then they want to know more.
We can see the face of Jesus in people and experiences, but example yeah. goes a long way. They wonder where do you get this joy? Where do you get right. peace? How do you handle things so well? How does not much bother you? And how That's are you right. so strong? And is that also available for me? Actually, it's available for all. It's available for yeah. everyone. And so, yes, then we talk about God. And it's not just enough to say, I found God, and therefore I help others and I talk to them about God. But there's also, we succeed, we prosper. God intended for us to have fruitful lives and to prosper.
Well, that's how they see our lives. They see that we're doing well and we're doing okay, and Jesus is protecting us. He's providing, and everything works out.
I know that when yeah. I didn't have God, nothing seemed to work out. It seemed like I had a dark right. cloud over my head, and I was always running into problems and into troubles and right. hitting dead walls. I mean, big right. walls. And there were no open doors for me. And so with God, one door closes, another one opens, and that door that opens right. is better. And right. so when something doesn't work out where you think it's supposed to happen a certain way, you find out that God had a better idea. And right. it works out even to the benefit, not just of yourself, but to most. And so God is always surprising us and never letting us down. He never ceases to amaze me.
No. My daughter tried to get a job. She got so upset she couldn't get that job. And then I said, just pray about it. God's got, he knows what's best for you, and he's got a plan. The next day, she was offered a job paying twice as much and a better job.
There you go.
The hours were more fitting for her. And I said, see, I told you. That's why he didn't get the other job. He had another plan.
Exactly. And when I'm tempted to worry or to be doubtful about things, because the enemy will always try to impregnate doubt in our minds and make us worry. He loves us stressing because that could cause conflict. And so when I'm tempted for that, I always remember what Padre Pio said. He said, worry about nothing, pray about everything. So
right.
anytime exactly. something looks weird or scary, because the devil will, that's an oppression. Don't trust an oppression. A psalm says, do not trust the oppression.
Right.
So don't trust it. Just pray. Just pray and know that yeah. God will come through. And even if it goes south, it's God's perfect will. It's okay.
Right.
Let's say you get a kid and he's difficult. Well, you know what? I was difficult too. But they loved me anyway. Yeah. Hey, didn't God say love them anyway? So
right.
and
he loves us no matter what we do.
Well, the more
he
difficult
still waits for us to come back. He's still there.
And the more difficult, the sweeter the song. I'm telling you, if you can help save a strong soul, that's greater than gold, greater than any diamonds, greater than $1 million. It's at least you did at least something good in your life, and you served a great purpose, and that's better than giving somebody money, but that you can talk to them about God and show them the light and show them how to find joy and happiness even in dark moments, to find the
right
to let God be the light in their darkness, and to be joyful and grateful no matter what.
Right.
And that's peace.
And that is.
And only God can give that. And only God can provide that.
Right.
But you have to have God. And it takes
right.
hard work. It takes commitment.
Well,
it takes doing
it
the right
does.
Thing.
It's not an easy road. But
no.
it is a better road. And it's a peaceful road because you don't worry so much because you got God with you. Even though it's hard, it's easier with Him.
God makes it easy. He smooths the way
right.
if we give Him our will. But if we do what
yep.
most everybody else is doing in the world, that's not what gets us to heaven, because He said
wow.
only few will make it to heaven. It isn't most.
That's right.
And we're not of
that's
this
right.
world. We're of the Spirit. So how do we
right.
know we're not acting like the world? Well, we look at the Bible, we go by his word. What was it that his word said? Because we could be easily deceived and easily manipulated. The devil is much smarter than us. We have to constantly pray for wisdom and ask the Holy Spirit to guide us through the darkness of sin, because it's so easy to fall. Barbara, we have just a few seconds, and you know, just one last thought for our listeners.
Yes, I just keep turning to God. Just keep asking the Lord to show you where to go and what to do, and just give your heart and your life to the Lord. Get rid of the word self. It's about Jesus. It's not about us. And he'll take care of you. Well, you don't have to take care of yourself.
Just trust he will, and you'll experience his marvels.
That's right.
Well, we're done with the show. Barbara, thank you so much for being with us. It was a pleasure having you, and thank you for your service.
Thank you so much. God bless.
You too.
Thank you.
Have a beautiful day.
You too. Bye-bye.
And bye. So we'll finish with a prayer, like we always do. Father, I come to you today, bowing in my heart, asking for protection from the evil one. Lord, we are assailed moment by moment with images on television, the internet, books, and newspapers that leave us vulnerable to sin of every kind. Surround us with your divine hedge of protection. Encompass us round about with your strength and your might. Let all who take refuge in you be glad. Let them ever sing for joy. And may you shelter us, and those who love your name may exult in you. For it is you who blesses the righteous man. O Lord, you surround him, favor as with a shield. Amen. And Lord, please have mercy. Oh, that's my addition. Thank you to the wonderful people that work with us and for having us in the air. Amazing Grace. Please check out Robbie Dilmer's show, The Christian Guy, and Kingdom Pursuit. He does two shows. Wow, what a busy guy. He's pretty great, very experienced. He's funny, great topics, and amazing guests. You might learn a few things, one or two, about cars.
We have.
I guess. Yes. But remember, you've been listening to The Cure with Aimee Cabo.
Yeah, you're Aimee.
With an A-I-M-E-E.
There you are, that Aimee. Please check our podcast, The Cure with Aimee Cabo. Our website, The God is the Cure. Our app, The Cure. All the shows are there.
So thank you to our listeners for being with us. And until next Saturday, much love. Always give it your best. Be as kind as possible to yourself and everyone. True in every situation. Keep your values. Don't lose hope, but most importantly, no matter what, keep the faith. And peace be with you. God's peace.
Thank you for listening to The Cure with Aimee Cabo. For more information or to get Aimee's book, Love is the Answer, God is the Cure, or to listen to the podcast of previous shows, visit GodIsTheCure.com.